Chelsea, and welcome back to my channel. For today's video, we are unboxing May's Illumicrate. Presley is absolutely dying over here to open this. I was trying to take some thumbnail pictures first for other stuff, and he was like not having it. He wants to open this so bad. So we are. I actually left my scissors over there, so let me get that so I can do the tape and I'll be right back. Okay, so tape is done. I'm very excited for this box. Our theme is going to be Change Your Stars. And yeah, very, very excited. Let's have him dive in, I guess, because he's ready for it. Oh, we want to take the paper out. Oh, look at that. This is pretty cool. So this, he's going to hold it. I will show you guys in just a second. It looks like a tea tin. We have some tins like this that my husband and his parents got at like the Asian market that actually has like tea and stuff in them. So I'm gonna start on this side and show you how pretty this is. It's like a phoenix and stuff. Like there's different types of animals, mythological animals on there, but it is very pretty. Here's like what the top looks like. I know there's some glare because it's shiny and I have like the window, like the blinds open. Are you gonna show the camera? Thank you. Can I look at it now? Here, get more stuff. Get more stuff out of there for Mama. So it's Elemental Creatures Tea Tin, inspired by the Dave Abad trilogy, which does make sense because on the bottom there is a quote from S.A. Chakraborty. And it says, all the elements, earth, fire, water, air, have their own creatures. Okay. Thank you. He does not want me to show you guys today. Under the lid, so here's the lid. We do have this then, and so has two different lids. But yeah, I knew what this was as soon as I saw it, because it definitely reminds me of, I don't know exactly what kind of tea my parents-in-law would actually get, but when they were living with us, we had some tea tins because it had tea in them. Okay, the next thing we have here. Ooh. Ooh, this is very, very pretty. I'm assuming it's just like a notebook, but I'm loving the art on here. And it says, ideas are so much wilder than memories, from V.E. Schwab. Okay, and apparently this is from The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue. I have not read that yet, even though I do own it. And actually, sketchbook, not notebook, it's not lined. And the paper actually feels pretty nice. But this is like a sketchbook. This is actually really cool. Here's the back. I think it's the same design as on the front, but without the quote. I actually really enjoy this. I go through notebooks a lot. One of the things that I do, which is not necessarily the probably the best way to do it, but when I film videos like this, I will then make notes as I'm editing it about stuff that I've said I wanted to include in videos or leave in the description, because I don't like script anything out. Everything is just off the cuff, so I never remember what I have specified that I need to include for you guys. So one of the things that I definitely do is have notebooks everywhere on my desk, and I just jot down the things that I need to mention or the books that I did mention. So yeah, I actually really enjoy this. Next, we have something in a white pouch here. Usually that means it's our pin. So yes, this is gonna be the pin of the month inspired by the book. Actually, let me take it out of the plastic so you guys can actually see it. I'm covering up the book of the month, just so if you wanna be surprised, you can be. Just a second. There we go, okay, there you go, you can have it. He loves the pins. Ooh, what is this? This is another pin. Let me, I guess, take it out of the plastic. But it is a dress, and it's from Novel Threads. You can have this in a second. You can have this in a second. Okay, this pin is really gorgeous. This is a gorgeous dress. Just a second. You can have the pin in a second. And it says, it's the most exquisite dress I have ever seen, even including the outfits the other girls wore on the first night at the palace. This one outshines them all. And according to our spoiler sheet, this is a Girls of Paper and Fire dress pin. It's really, really pretty. I have not read that book yet, even though I do own it. So yeah. Interesting. Huh. Okay. So we have an enamel key is what they have here. This is sort of cool. I definitely think these are going to be like very like collectible item type of things. And this is Imbot from Skyward. And it does have a very tiny hole at the top, so you could probably put like on a key ring. Just a second. You can have it in just a second. And here is the back. This is very, very interesting to me. It does say that this is the first key in our latest collection, and it can be used to gain access to Imbot. So I'm assuming, I don't know how often we're gonna get these, but this is a collection that Illumicrate is doing. I'm actually really on board for this. These are quite heavy as well. Like, they feel really nice, like a nice collectible item. So yeah, I'm very excited about this. This one was done by Danielle. I will leave all of the artists and creators down below, but the reason I'm saying that is this is a name that I recognize from my most recent unboxing that I actually just did the other day. I will leave it linked down below, which was the Infernal Devices Special Edition crate from Illumicrate. And yeah, this, I really, really enjoyed that. Okay. And then we have a book sleeve with our book in it. This does say it's a Stark Castle book sleeve from Spinning Silver. I have not read that one either. That's actually, don't touch the camera, please. That's actually not even on my list to read anywhere compared to like everything else that's on here. I've read Skyward. Everything else on here except for Spinning Silver, I do have on my want to read list, or I own the book already. So yeah, this is a really, really pretty, really nice book sleeve. But I don't know if I'm ever going to read Spinning Silver. It just doesn't seem necessarily like my thing. But like I said, really cool book sleeve. And then we are down to our book. This book is so much thicker than I thought it was going to be. I hardly ever actually look at page number when I mark things on Goodreads as want to read. It's just not something that I'm concerned with. Oh, a box from our last unboxing. There you go. It's not something I'm concerned with. Like, I love long books and stuff, but sometimes I don't know. I just have an idea in my head of like how thick something's going to be. But I do also think Illumicrate in general, their special editions look thicker to me in general, because I feel like the paper that they use is usually pretty nice thick paper. Okay, but here we go. This one does come with a signed book plate from the author. We also have an author letter with some art on the back. Very, very pretty. But it is going to be The Jasmine Throne by Tasha Suri. I am super, super excited, but like, look at how thick this looks. It looks so thick. I don't know why I feel like it's super, super thick. But I'm very excited for this one. I don't know too much about it, except for I do believe there's like an exiled, is she a princess? I don't know if she's necessarily a princess, but like, I think her brother is on the throne and she's been like put in prison. And then one of the people that is like serving her food and stuff is going to help her get out of there. I don't know for sure too much else. I do believe this is also going to be sapphic, which is exciting. And look how gorgeous. We have stenciled edges all the way around the book that like match the stuff going on the cover. Oh, it's so, so pretty. Ooh, and underneath, here is what it looks like. We have the flower that's also on the spine, and it says, "Together they will change the fate of an empire." Ooh, and here it says, "A vengeful princess, a hidden priestess." Okay, I think the hidden priestess is like the person that's like taking food up to the princess. So yeah, I'm very, very excited for this. And if you can see on the pages, I don't know if you're actually going to be able to tell, down here, the gray stuff, I just double checked, that's like where the extras start. So there's gonna be extras in here, probably like author interviews and maybe questions and stuff, I don't know. But yeah, I didn't know exactly how long I expected this book to be, and it feels very chunky. It's only like 533 pages, so this does feel extra chunky for that, but Illumicrate's quality of like how they bind their books up and stuff, the page thickness is always like really, really nice. So yeah, very, very excited about this one. Let's not mess up the author letter and stuff. Let's leave those in there. Okay, and then next month, the theme is Out of the Woods, and they did have a sneak peek. This month's jigsaw will be inspired by Lord of the Rings. Okay, one, I didn't know we were getting a puzzle, but two, I'm a sucker for Lord of the Rings. So yes, very, very excited. That will be it, since now he's giving me all my things back. And yeah, if you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up to let me know. Subscribe to this channel if you would like to see new videos. I do have videos up Tuesdays and Thursdays. Because I'm doing live playthroughs of Mass Effect Legendary Edition on Saturday and Sunday. So this is actually an extra video for you guys coming up on Saturday. Once you're done here, if you wanted to join me over in playing live Mass Effect, definitely go do that. This video is coming up at 8 a.m. I will be live at 9 a.m., so just an hour after this goes up. So if you have time, please think about joining me. It's a lot of fun. I haven't played this game in years, and so some of it I'm a little bit, like, confused by, but we're having a lot of fun. So I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!